I lived in the desert seven, eight years alone. Bedouins, the family of the Falataik, they taught me everything. They taught me how to live in the desert, how to deal with camels. And they taught me how to track snakes and how to live and to live their way and to survive. I was born in Palestine, 1935, in the middle of a civil war, started by the English. And when I was 3 years old, we had to leave because the family would have been assassinated, because my father fought the British. So I ended up in the States. I grew up in New York. Can't lose the accent. But I was never allowed to come back. I was never allowed to visit. In 94, I finally said, all right, I have to do this. Of course, by this time, it's Israel. So I lived in Jerusalem 94, 95, 96, and I was supposed to teach at Beersheba University because I do sculptures and glass. And it didn't work out, so they said, well, do what you want. So I took some archaeology courses because I also do that. And then I got into the region and the area. The manager of the archaeological dig, and he said, well, go to Wadi Rum. Just go there. Just go there. I'm not saying anything more. You'll understand. Just go there. And that's how I got here. And it is. It's a beautiful place. And, you know, you go where your path leads you to go. I had a camel. And the signal was that if anything was wrong, I would tie a rope around her neck and send her home. And home was Wadi Rum because she was born there. See, camels go where they were born. Mm-hmm. So she was okay. So if anything went wrong, I would send her home. And then at some point later, somebody would come. I would take onions, potatoes. I lived on a lot of dried fruits, figs, dates. I lived on dates and camel's milk for a while. Perfect food. Raisins, nuts. I'm not a meat eater. I mean, I could walk an hour and a half, 2 hours, I could be in the village if I had to walk. And there was always somebody going by at some point. There are certain things you have to have always with you. Matches, water, and a compass. At least until you learn. I mean, I could walk from here because I knew what, I lived long enough to understand, memorize this area and know it. And it was the first wide open area, you know, and I knew by the shape of rocks that this was, and of course you could see the campsite. But a compass is done to teach you the directions the sun is going in. You know, you've got to see, where does the sun come up? That's east. You want to get back to the village, you have to go to the west. But basically that's how I lived. It was in areas like this where there was an overhang. You could sit inside.
Yeah.
I never had this. This is... I lived with nature all my life. In Portugal, I lived on top of a mountain. Everybody thought I was nuts. But it was beautiful. I live everywhere. I live everywhere. It makes me weird. I live with 5,000 books, 25 million sheets of paper, 2 file cabinets, full. I was married twice. I had 2 sons from the first husband. One is 50 and one is 45, so I don't think they really need me anymore. One is a musician. He writes and composes and teaches, so. And the other one goes through different stages where he doesn't want to talk to his mother. So, you know, when he changes his mind, it's all right. For now, we're happy. Yeah. Yeah, I can. No, we contact. You can talk through Skype. They have their lives and I have mine. My family is the people who I live with or the people who I work with. That's my family. The people you get along with, that's your family. Well, I've been here 14 years. I'm 76. I'll probably say another 2-3 years, and then I think, depending on what happens in the world, I can always go back to Portugal. I lived there 27 years. I know people. I had a house. I sold it. I know the language. But I don't know if I want to do that because I don't like the way things are going. I don't know what the rest of my life is, and I don't know what that means. So if I can't find any other place to live, maybe I'll end up here, but I don't worry about it. When the time comes to make that decision, I will make it. Thank you.